50 past the hour, time for your winter weather update as we bring in storm tracker Jim Cantore.
And Jim, we're definitely focusing in on the west, and a good thing this storm is now in November and not, say, in January or February with all this rain coming in.
Yeah, I mean, this could be, a disaster already, Paul, because we're talking about very high snow levels. So instead of that snow being down to, let's say, 4,000 feet, the snow is going to be way up from 7,000 feet up. All right, so now you've got below 7,000 feet all rain. And that's a lot more water into the watershed and potentially flooding. So we're going to be watching that. As Forbes said, he expects major flood stage out of some of these rivers here. We've had some issues today around San Francisco. California Highway Patrol reporting minor road flooding in Alameda County. We had a 72-mile-per-hour wind gust measured at 1,742 feet. And here's our monster right out and through this big pinwheel here. We've already had one of the spokes of the wheel, which is kind of broken off and come into California. And you can see the main part of that is actually moved to the east. And we're on the sinking side of it, but because the flow is aimed up the mountains, we are still getting precipitation here. As a matter of fact, let's go ahead and take you out into Donner Summit, and you can see what's going on in through here. Al's going to kind of show me what's happening in through there. There's Donner Summit right there. You can see the roads are snow-packed a little bit, certainly, especially the entrance ramps in through here, but traffic's moving along. They've got their flashers on from time to time, and of course, chains are required for some of the big rigs up and through there. Not surprising, given the fact that we have had the snow. But look at that camera. Just shaking. So there's some, you can see the trees right up here. So big wind, certainly for the higher elevations. Not surprising we've had some of these gusts. You know what? Expect that wind to pretty much continue right through Monday. So here it is. Think about a tire, all right? There's the center of the tire. Here's one spoke. Here's another spoke. Here's another spoke, and here's another spoke. We will deal with these three right here over the next 72 to 96 hours, and that means a lot of unsettled weather for the west, and I think with each one of these, we will even see heavier rainfall. So, spoke number one is producing some rain really all along the California coast. We've had some rain through Los Angeles. The International Airport reporting 1/100th now. Looks like a heavier pot of rain getting ready to move in south of L.A., to the north of Oceanside, so we'll see some rain come in there. Here's the rain we just showed you on Donner, and rain and snow, I should say, that we showed you around Donner Pass. That continues to impact this area again, even though I mentioned the main disturbance is by, but you've got the fact that the moist flow is still now kind of perpendicular to the mountain, so we're kind of squeezing out all the available moisture in through here. And rain's starting to come to an end down around Tacoma and Olympia, as it's pretty much raining from Seattle up through Everett and continuing up through Bellingham as well. Just kind of a miserable night here as temperatures are sitting in the 40s. So that's spoke number one, but where do we go from here? Let's ask the model to mimic out what is going to happen. So by tomorrow, we're already into this next system. This is all steady rain back down to the Bay Area. There could even be some thunderstorms here with this, too. A lot of instability, a lot of moisture. And the moisture doesn't just impact California and Oregon. It's going to make its way eventually, we think, especially by Friday and into the weekend, over into Idaho and into Montana, where snow levels here are going to be about 6,500 feet. And we are going to be talking about probably some of the heaviest snow with the entire event. So let's ask the model to add up the rain right through Monday. And yeah, we're almost off the charts and through here, as we've been mentioning with Dr. Forbes, 6 to 12 inches in Northern California, the Mount Shasta, Siskiyou region, Redding, on over to Eureka and Arcata, California, all these areas into Southern Oregon as well, expecting a lot of rain. But look at the snow, interestingly enough, especially for the Sierra. Not much is forecast here because the snow levels are actually going to go up to 8,000 to 9,000 feet, and they're going to be high, too, as well in Oregon. So that's why we're concerned about all these areas underneath 7,000 feet, adding to the watershed and probably creating a worse flood situation. So, you know, it'd actually be better, Paul, if we had snow levels down to about 4,000 feet. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Jim.
And thank you for staying with us tonight on Weather Center Live. Coming up next, Coast Guard Florida.
And then the season premiere of Coast Guard Alaska. We're back for Weather Center Live at 10 p.m. Eastern Time.